ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो 7 चैप्टर 15 टेक्स्ट नंबर 34 इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर सिविलाइज्ड ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। एवं इन दिस वे अभ्यासता ऑफ द पर्सन प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस योगा चित्तम कालेन अल्पियास यते अनीशं तस्या निर्वाणं याति अनिंधना वहनी वत। एवं अभ्यासतः वित्तम् एवं अभ्यायसतः चित्तम् काले नाल्पवीयते काले ना अल्पियसार्यते अनिशं तस्य निर्वाणं यात्य अनिन्दं वहनीवत् याति अनिन्धान वहनीवत् एवं अभ्यायसतः चित्तं काले न अल्पियसायते अनीशं तस्य निर्वाणं याति अनिन्धन वहनिवत् एवं इन दिस वे अभ्यायसतः ऑफ द पर्सन प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस योगा सिस्टम चित्तम द हार्ट कालेन इन ड्यू कोर्स ऑफ टाइम अल्पियसा वेरी शॉर्टली यते ऑफ द पर्सन प्रैक्टिसिंग योगा अनीशम विदाउट सेसेशन तस्या ऑफ हिम निर्वाणम प्यूरिफिकेशन फ्रॉम ऑल मेटेरियल कंटेमिनेशन याति रीचेस अनिंधन विदाउट फ्लेम और स्मोक वहनिवान लाइक ए फायर translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki. When the yogi regularly practices in this way, in a short time his heart becomes fixed and free from disturbance, like a fire without flames or smoke. Please repeat after me. When the yogi regularly practices in this way, in a short time his heart becomes fixed and free from disturbance, like a fire without flames or smoke. Purport. Nirvana means the cessation of all material desires. Sometimes desirelessness is understood to imply an end to the workings of the mind, but this is not possible. The living entity has senses, and if the senses stopped working, the living entity would no longer be a living entity. He would be exactly like a stone or wood. This is not possible because he is living. He is Nitya and Chetna, eternally sentient. For those who are not very advanced, the practice of yoga is recommended in order to stop the mind from being agitated by material desires. But if one fixes his mind on the lotus feet of Krishna, his mind naturally becomes peaceful very soon. This peace is described in Bhagavad Gita 5.29, Yoginam abhi sarve bhoktaram yagya tapsam sarva lokamaheshwaram surda sarva bhutanam gyatma mam shantim rachyati. If one can understand Krishna as a supreme enjoyer, the supreme proprietor of everything, and the supreme friend of everyone, one is established in peace and is free from material agitation. However, for one who cannot understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the practice of yoga is recommended. Om Jnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalagaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. When the yogi regularly practices in this way, in a short time his heart becomes fixed and free from disturbance, like a fire without flame or smoke. So in this very powerful verse, and in this couple of significant words, Prabhupada mentioned first of all is nirvana. And nirvana means, Prabhupada is explaining, cessation of material desires. But then further in the purport, Prabhupada says, that's not possible. Why? Nahi kashi shanam api jatu tishthati karam akrat. There cannot be even a single moment in our life when we are sitting and doing nothing. We must act. Karyate vesha karma sar prakritir jargunair. We are born under certain modes of influence, three modes of material nature. We are born under them and we must act accordingly. But for whom we have to work? Yagyarthat karma no nyatra loko yam karma bandhana tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sangha samachara. So we have to work for yagya, Vishnu, Krishna. Otherwise what happens? We get trapped in loko yam karma bandhana. We get bound in the reactions of our actions. So what this nirvana means exactly? Like in Buddhist philosophy, they call it ghatakash patakash. Ghatakash patakash means our body is just like a container, like a ghada, earthen pot. And when the pot breaks, nothing is there, blissful nothingness. Nothing happens after death. We are just merged, shunyavadi. निर्विशेष शून्यवादी नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिण निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतान श्रील प्रभुपाद ही डिड दैट ही डिलीवर्ड हिज मैसेज टू दोज हु बिलीव्ड इन निर्विशेष इम्पर्सनलिज्म एंड शून्यवादी वर्डिज्म मायावाद असत शास्त्रम प्रच्छन्नम बौद्ध्यम उच्यते. सो लॉर्ड शिवा इज स्पीकिंग टू हिज वाइफ पार्वती उमा दैट मायावाद असत शास्त्रम प्रच्छन्नम बौद्ध्यम उच्यते. इट्स प्रच्छन्न मीन्स इज कवर्ड. मायावाद इज कवर्ड बुद्धिज्म. प्रच्छन्नम बौद्ध्यम उच्यते स्पीक्स एंड I will come, like Lord Shiva is talking to Parvati, I will come as a Brahmana, which we know all Shankaracharya, and will preach Mayavad. So look now, several times people asked us while we preach in America, and then people ask, but why this Buddha is Krishna himself? Shiva is the greatest devotee of the Lord Krishna. Why would they do this? Buddha is preaching voidism, Shankara is preaching nirvishesha, Mayavad, these are devotees, or Krishna himself as Buddha, why he talked like that? So Prabhupada in one of his lectures he mentioned that why Lord Buddha came, because Krishna came about 5000 years ago and he spoke Bhagavad Gita. And everything was very nicely said and done. But when Krishna saw Dhammo Bhagate, Dharma Jnana Divisa, Kalau Drashtina Shameshe, Puranar Godhunar Dita, Krishna saw Dhammo Bhagate, Krishna went to his own Dham abode. Dharma Jnana Divisa, all religiosity, spirituality, Dharma, Jnana, the transcendental knowledge, all went with him. What happened then after that? Puranarka, then he got himself in Puranarka, Mahapuran, Bhagavat Puran, he is in this. So he is established himself in this. And also, in Kali Santaran Upanishad, like sometimes people say, in one of the purports, in this chapter, somewhere Prabhupada mentioned that Pranava Omkar, or Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So some devotees, they put wrongly this way on their some Facebook. Recently I was reading that the same chanting Omkar Om and chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, the same. They misinterpret that and put that line somewhere. So we should not quote Srila Prabhupada out of context. That's a mistake. One time a representative from United Nations was speaking to Srila Prabhupada and he asked, what is the difference between the two? Prabhupada said, they are same, but. So whenever we quote Prabhupada, we have to keep but together. If we leave but away, then we misinterpret Prabhupada. So Prabhupada explained, like for example, I am here in the Kirtan and I call, hey white shirt come here, or white kurta come here. May not turn away, that person may not turn around because I said white shirt. So Om is just like a white shirt, come here. Unless I add Hari Om, that's become complete. Now I'm saying Hari, Lord, Krishna, Vishnu, then it's become complete. So Om is more towards impersonalism. It's more towards, that's why it's like all pervading. So we don't want to, we chant Hare Krishna Mantra. Why we chant Hare Krishna Mantra? Many reasons. In Kali Santaran Upanishad, it is mentioned Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Vyasadev, he wrote all the Vedas, all the Puranas, all the Upanishads, and in Kali Santaran Upanishad, which is meant for Kali Yuga, he mentioned this mantra, and after this mantra he said, Iti Shodash Kam Namam, this holy names, comprising Shodashaka, 16 words, 16 names. Hare means invocative of Hara. Hara is Radharani. And when we address Radharani, oh Radharani, oh Radhe, Hare, oh Radhe, Hare. So we say, oh Radharani, please engage me in the service of Krishna, most attractive, and Rama, the supreme enjoyer. Simple prayer. We chant this prayer every day. Please engage me in the service. So, iti shodashakam namam kali kalmasha nashanam. This mantra comprising of 16 words, 16 holy names, can destroy all the vices, all the impurities of Kali Yuga, of the age of Kali. Kavichand Maharaj ki jai. So, khalo iti, sorry, iti shodasha kam namam kali kalmasha nashanam nata paratara upaya. There is no better remedy than this mantra. Sarva vedeshu drishyate. After looking into the whole huge vast body of Vedic literature, Vedvyas, he is the literary incarnation of Krishna, Shri Krishna Dvaipayan Vyasadev. He is not an ordinary person. He is a Parusheya. He is not an ordinary person like us. He is literary incarnation of Krishna. He wrote all the whole body of Vedas. And he is saying, I am saying, after looking at the whole body of Vedic literature. So can we go through the whole body of Vedic literature? No. We have no time. Vedvyas has solved our life. He made things easy for us. He wrote so many things, but at the end he said, don't worry. Just chant this Hare Krishna mantra. You will be fixed in Kali Yuga. For example, I become sick and I go to a doctor, to a physician, and tells him, Doctor sahab, I am sick. Before doctor begins speaking, I said, don't speak, please don't speak. Give me that medicine in your shelf. And doctor will say, I am doctor, you came to me and you are not allowing me to speak and just asking that medicine, how is that possible? I know what disease you have. You have disease of Kali Yuga. And for that, you need this medicine. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Why bother with so many mantras mentioned there? There are so many medicines in my shelf, not for you. Don't bother about them. So this Nirvana is another example Prabhupada gave in his lectures. For example, I become sick. And at my home, and I have wife. And because I'm sick, I have fever. And to understand the full analogy, fever means fever of material desire. I want this, I want this, I want that, I want that. Give me this. More and more and more sense gratification I want. This is fever. Material fever. And I'm suffering. And I'm lying on my bed. And my wife is bringing juice to me. I want pakodi. He said, no, you cannot take pakodi, you take khichdi. Okay. I'm taking khichdi, juice, medication. And after a week, my fever goes down and I'm okay. And I'm lying on my bed and my wife comes to me. What are you doing, Prabhu? You are okay. Get up now. Do the work here. I'm alone since working last 1 week, whole week by myself. You didn't help at all for last 1 week. Get up, take your shower, put your clothes on, help me in the kitchen, go to your work. So if I do not rise from my bed after my disease is cured, my fever is down, that's called Nirvana. My material fever is gone. But if I do not place myself in my constitutional position, my daily routine, my life, my duty, my constitution, eternal vision. Mukti hitva anyatha rupam swarupena avasthiti. I become situated in my constitutional position. What is my constitutional position? Jivere swarup hai nitya krishnera das. We are eternally servant of Krishna. We are eternally, we have been serving him. Somehow or other, we got into this material world and began to think, I am God. I want to enjoy like God. I want to enjoy separate from God. The moment I begin to think, here I am in this material world. So Lord Buddha, and believe it or not, when, so why, the original question I put early on, why Krishna came as Buddha and preached voidism? Why Shiva came as Shankaracharya and preached impersonalism? So these are the questions we have at this point today, and we are going to answer them through Prabhupada's purpose and lectures. So in one lecture, Prabhupada was saying that Lord Krishna came, he gave Bhagavad Gita, the process was there, but then what happened? Jayadeva Goswami, he wrote his Dasavatar, and in that mentioned 10 incarnations of Lord Krishna, and one of them he said, Nindasi Yajna Vidheraha Shruti Jatam Sadaya Hirdaya Darshita Pashukhatam Keshamadrita Buddha Sharira Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare. Nindasi Yajna Vidher Ahaha Shruti Jatam. So what people, Lord Krishna left, and after a couple of thousands of years ago, what people began to do, they began to eat meat. They began to kill animals in fire sacrifice, bali, based on Shruti, Ahaha Shruti, quoting Shruti. Shruti is what? Shruti, Smriti, Puranadi, Pancharatri ki Vidhim Bina. So what? They were quoting, look, in Markandeya Puran, it is mentioned, you can offer an animal in fire sacrifice, and what you do after that, you eat. But that was not the purpose. They were misinterpreting Markandeya Puran. They were misunderstood Markandeya Puran. It was meant to give a new life to the animal, not to just kill and eat. But they misinterpreted. And because of that misinterpretation, what happened? Lord Buddha came because we follow four regularity principles to become purified. No meat eating, no illicit sex, no gambling, no intoxication. Because ahar nidra bhay maithunam cha, eating, meeting, sleeping, defending. Samanyam etat pashu bhi naranam. These are common between man and animal. Pashubhi naranam. Ahar nidra bhay maithunam. Eating, mating, sleeping, defending. These four things are common between us and animals. So what extra do we have? Dharmo hi eko adhiko vishesho. We have extra, very unique feature in our human form of life, that we can discriminate, we can distinguish. Bhagavatam says, one living entity is the food of another living entity. But that is what? That is in jungle, that is a forest. One living entity is food of another living entity. But in civilized human form of life, that is not the case. We have prerogative, we have choice, we have understanding. We are not meat-eating animals. We are civilized vegetarian humans. We are prasadatarian. Patram pushvam phalam toyam यो मे भक्त्याभिरच्छति, वी ऑफर एवरीथिंग टू द लॉर्ड. व्हाई? बिकॉज यज्ञाशिष्टशिना संतो मुच्यन्ते एक सर्व किल विषय भुंजति ते त्वघं पाप ये पचन्ति आत्मकारणात्. डिवोटीज ऑफ द लॉर्ड दे कुक वेरी नाइस डेलिशियस टेस्टी भोगा टू ऑफर टू लॉर्ड कृष्णा एंड देन टेक महाप्रसाद. अदरवाइज व्हाट हैपेंस? दोज हू कुक फॉर देयर ओन सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन पचंती आत्मकारणात, व्हाट हैपेंस टू देम? भुंजति ते त्वघं पाप. भुंजति मीन्स दे आर ईटिंग देयर ओन सिन. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी राइज इन द मॉर्निंग, बिकॉज हियर प्रभुपाद सेज दैट वेरी नाइस, वेरी नाइस पावरफुल लाइन द वेरी एंड ऑफ द पर्वत. हाउएवर फॉर वन हु कैनॉट अंडरस्टैंड द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड, द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ योगा इज रिकमेंडेड. सो वॉट इज दिस योगा? ह्यूज वर्ड योगा. लाइक द अदर डे इन अवर यूनिवर्सिटी वी हैव ए लैब sustainable environmental and agricultural research lab, and in that we talk about organic farming and how to use compost and how to not use the pesticide, herbicide, insecticides because they are causing cancers. So the ambassador of Costa Rica, she also very much Mariela, she also very much preaches. She had been to India for 16 years traveling here and there. She became fan of Indian culture. She got initiation, everything. So we invited her to, because she is a promoter of organic farming, so we invited her to inaugurate our lab. And before that, we were meeting her, and she said, oh, so I like the philosophy, the culture, the food, the people of India very much. Can you tell me about yoga? I said, ma'am, yoga is a very, Y-O-G-A, very small, but a huge definition behind it, huge detail behind it, is very much misinterpreted at this time. Very much. Yoga, people, Ashtanga yoga. People do all these acrobatics and things, and this pranayama, that is all yoga. But that's not it. That's not enough. It's a whole yoga ladder. So Prabhupada is saying in the Purport, like in 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, you just think of me, manmanabhav, it's not in 12, but manmanabhav bhakto madhyaji mam namaskaru. You pray to me, you come to me, you pay your homage to me, you worship me, you bow down to me. But then some people may say, but Krishna is asking too much. They may not be, like one time long back, I met, because there are many different levels of consciousness. So we were talking to some old gentleman in India long back, and he said, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna, what he does, simply glorify himself. I am this, I am water, I am Himalaya, I am this, I am that, I am that. And it's very difficult to understand. Okay, don't worry. If you don't understand it, then Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, 12th chapter, that you then follow the regulations of Bhakti Yoga. So what are the regulations of Bhakti Yoga? Like we have Sadhana Bhakti, we have Bhava Bhakti, Prema Bhakti, but to go to that platform we have Sadhana Bhakti, and within Sadhana Bhakti we have two, Vaidhi Bhakti and Raganuga Bhakti. In Raganuga, spontaneous, but we are not that platform also. So what we do? We follow Vaidhi Bhakti. In Vaidhi Bhakti, we follow Vaidhi Vidhi, Vidhi Vidhan, rules and regulations. Rise in the morning 4 o'clock. If you rise 3 o'clock and take bath, that's Amrit Snan. It's like a nectar is being showered on you at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's okay in summer, but when in winter, it's really Amrit. So the thing is, we have to rise in the morning, come to Mangal Aarti, chant our 16 rounds, attend Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya, attend every day the Bhagavatam class. One time, some devotees, they were outside and class was going on. And Prabhupada came around and he said, devotees were walking outside, class was going inside. But why are you not inside the class? Prabhu, a new bhakta is giving class. Maharaj, oh, Swamiji, Prabhupada, a new bhakta is giving class and we know what is there, so we are just outside chanting. Prabhupada, no. Do you know the definition of less advanced and advanced bhakta? It's not by seniority. Oh, Prabhu, I got initiation in 1984 and now 2018, so I'm that much senior. Okay, good to know. But then, advancement means not that how many years you have been in ISKCON. Advancement means we present ourselves not at the platform we are. We present lower than that, much lower than that. That's how we advance. Trinada Peshuni Chena. We say, no, Prabhu, it's my fault. I have been chanting for so many years and still have so many desires. So you can call me senior, but that's like a, I don't want to hear that because I'm not exactly on that platform. So if we say or think like that, then we never think of ourselves advanced, but that's what the advancement means, that we present ourselves lower than what we are. Not then, generally it happens, we try to present ourselves, we sometimes act like that hypocritically, we all, myself especially, we act like we are very advanced. I act like I'm advanced, but it's not true. Because we have to present ourselves at lower platform. That's advancement. So, many times, so what Krishna says in 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, that if you cannot just think of me 24 hours a day without fail, all the time, you are thinking of me. If that is not possible, to come to that platform, you come to this Vedi Sadhana Bhakti. You follow under the guidance. Take a spiritual master, follow scriptures, Shadhu Shastra Guru. If you do not follow scripture master, spiritual master, if you do not follow scriptures, if you do not take advice from saintly sadhus, like Guru, Sadhu, Shastra. Three things. For example, I was in London one time and I wanted to go to Trafalgar Square and I got off the airport and I went to the information booth and I asked the person standing over there, I want to go to Trafalgar Square. How should I go? He said, you can go by bus, you can go by taxi, because you are new, you may have to change, so, or it may take time. If you want to go fast, you take a taxi. Okay. Then he asked, do you have a map? He said, yes, we have a map of London. He gave me a map. So now I have a map. And I've asked him, he told me, the person at the information booth, he told me, you will go after 2 miles, after 2 kilometers, there will be a particular cinema hall, then on the right there will be Liberty, on the that side there will be this thing, and after 3-4 miles turning right, you will find this thing. He told me all of that and gave me a map. Then I went out and called a taxi. Now taxi driver is sitting, he is driving me towards Trafalgar Square. What else do I have besides the driver? I have two things. What two things? Number one, the map. And number two, the signs. He told me, turn left, turn right, you will find Odeon, this, that. Now, everything is said and done, driver is driving. So driver is just like Guru. And the map I got from the information booth is just like Bhagavad Gita. And the person standing on the information booth, he gave me some things, some hints. They're just like a words of a sadhu. And now I'm sitting, car is going, taxi is going, cab is going. And what is happening? Looking at the map on the right, yeah, road is right. Driver is okay. And then, oh, there's the Odeon cinema, okay, good. So three things are matching, I'm fine, I'm good, I'm doing okay. We have to match all the three. Whenever we stop doing that, we will be in trouble. We have to match all the three all the time. Not just one time and just I'm done. All the time. So what Krishna is saying in 12th chapter, that if you cannot think of me, me means Krishna, all the time, then what you do? You follow Vedi Sadhana Bhakti. So why all this? Ata Shri Krishna Namadi Na Bhaved Grahyam Indriya Sevan Mukhi Jivado Swam Eva Smrutiyada. So Krishna is saying, these name, form, qualities, pastimes of the Lord Na Bhaved Grahyam Indriya. My senses are blunt, so dull, I cannot perceive you, Krishna. What do you do? Sevan Mukhi Jivado Ado means when you start the process of bhakti, you do use of your tongue, Ado Jiva. Sevan Mukhi, you serve Krishna by your tongue. You begin the process. Of course, the beginning is the end. We chant Hare Krishna, we end up Hare Krishna, we are chanting here, we'll chant over there, we are serving here, we'll serve in Golok Vrindavan. Process and goal are the same. Only thing, we are practicing, 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 practicing. So smooth transition, just like aeroplane. When aeroplane lands, so the airport, airstrip is still not moving. Plane is moving. When landing, at least 200 kilometers per hour, at least. Plane is moving. Plane's wheels are not moving on which it's going to land. So what they do? They have a system. They give speed to wheels before landing. So when plane lands, it runs like this. If they would not move the wheel beforehand, will burst the tire, they will like this and will just, they will fire. So what they do? The wheel start moving beforehand. So what we are doing? We are preparing day by day, day by day, day by day ourselves by chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. This is the only thing. This is the only thing for devotees to follow very strictly. Rest of the things will come automatically. Like in one of the concerts in America, one devotee was, he wasn't a devotee at the time, but then he was standing and enjoying music. And devotees, they take opportunity, they got in. And sometimes these organizers of these touring musical bands, they allow devotees to go in. So, because somehow those people who come to these rock bands and things, they are not ordinary people. They are, you know, trying to find some pleasure in some bang bang music like that, and they think it can help. But they are seeking. So they are good candidates for Bhagavad Gita and things. So devotees, they sneak in. So one devotee gave a small book, Life Comes From, no. There was an Easy Journey to Other Planets. Very good book. Prabhupada wrote that very beginning, the very beginning. So he gave that book to a person. And person, because in America people are nice. In general, they won't hurt you. They won't hurt your feelings. If you give them a book, they will take it. 90%. And you can give me just a small printing cost. Little contribution, if you want to. If you don't, it's okay. So they gave. But then because he didn't want to read it, so he just threw in the air that book, and a person was standing and the book had your head like this, and he got the book. Wow, very nice. He went back home, read the book, became devotee, and he wrote an article, Mercy from Up Above. So he got mercy. The other time one devotee mentioned, because I read this digest very often, book distribution, devotees write their own experiences. So one devotee mentioned that he was these mobile phones, they came, I guess, 10, 15 years ago, not very before. So like in 1998 or something like that, some devotees, they were distributing books. But then this mobile phone came in. And practically you go to downtown, distribute books, everyone is talking on mobile phone. And you go to the book, Prabhu, we have a book for you. And he's just like, because he is talking on the phone to somebody. I said, I have this book, very good book, book on yoga, book on meditation, your life becomes successful. And the person is on mobile phone. And his girlfriend on the other hand, other end, she said to him, but to whom you're talking? Here's a guy, he's showing me a book on yoga, meditation. I told him several times, I don't want it, but he's still waving towards me. Oh, girlfriend sent from the other end. Oh, book on yoga, meditation. Oh, I want that. Grab the book. So this is mercy. The friend, the boyfriend didn't get any mercy, but his girlfriend, she got the mercy through mobile phone. So Sri Krishna acts mysteriously sometimes. Like, I'm not a book distributor, but one time I was out and it was a cooperative store. There are a lot of people come, they call it cooperative store, means all kinds of world food is there. So many times you find people of different style, different culture, philosophy. So there was a cowboy on his Mercedes, and I approached him and I said, hey, look, I have the books which will make you learn live simple life. What simple life means? Based on land and cow, you can live peacefully, you don't need much. He said, yeah, right, I also live on land and cow. What I do, I grow hay, chara, and feed to cow and eat their flesh, land and cow. Such a nice combination. I said, no, that's not the right way to live in land and cow, that's wrong, you're killing your mother. Better you take her milk. The milk is also coming from her blood. She's giving you her blood. And the guy, his box was open, he sat on the car and was just like, oh my God, what I was doing. Somehow it got clicked to him. He said, give me all the books, one copy of all the books that you have. Krishna acts mysteriously, many, many times. So, we are almost closing the class. But before that, I just want to make everyone laugh, because we want to be happy. Like husband and wife, one time they asked, one person asked the husband, you look very happy in your family life. You husband and wife go very nicely together. What is the secret? Yeah, trust and understanding are the two things our marriage is based upon. Now, how's that? She doesn't trust me and I don't understand her. Simple thing. That's our trust and understanding. So, our Krishna consciousness movement is meant for, like Prabhupada was in Los Angeles and all the professors, they came and one professor said, Swamiji, just tell me in one sentence your whole philosophy. Very difficult question. And Prabhupada said, and I remember that verse, I immediately memorized that verse, because Prabhupada was going to speak a verse which will summarize our whole thing for the professor. He said, dharmasya hi apavargasya nartho arthayopakalpate narthasya dharmekantasya kam lobhaya smrta. Canto 1, Chapter 2, Bhagavatam. Dharmasya hi apavargasya. Pavarg, papa, babama, parishram, phen, bhaya, mrityu. Hard work, foam coming from mouth, fear and death. This is pavarga. Apavarga, you go beyond this. Don't die. Take eternal life. So dharma, religiosity, spirituality is meant. You are all religionists, you are all spiritualists, you are professors of religion in different colleges or universities. What I'm telling you, religion means, philosophy means, spirituality means, you get out of the clutches of death. That is. So I will stop here and will open up for any questions. Thank you very, very much for all of you coming here and tolerating me for almost an hour. And I really appreciate, it's hot weather, it's humid weather, and the way devotees are doing these austerities. We need not to be go to Himalayas and sit in the snow naked, no. We just need to come to Bhagavatam class. That's the austerity recommended in Kali Yuga for us. Prabhupada is our Acharya, he gave us this process. So any questions or comments? If not, we'll stop here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Jaya Srila Prabhupada ki jaya.